we live in a world where there's up and down, and it's very solid. I mean, I can walk on the floor, I cannot walk on the ceiling. The up and down are a big part of our experience. However, when we go to school, we learn the equations of mechanics, and the Newton equations. There's no up and down in the world. If you go away from Earth, the astronauts in their little capsule, they don't have an up and down. They can turn around and all directions are the same. And if we are two astronauts in a capsule and I say, where is something? And you say, just look down, I don't know what you mean. There's no down. So in the universe, there's no up and down. Up and down are not part of the structure of the universe. However, they exist here. Why? Well, because there's a planet, there's attraction to the planet. So on this little layer around the Earth, there's a well-defined up and down. So we can at the same time think that some notions are not universal, are not part of the fabric of nature, but at the same time make sense for us. And I think it's a little bit like that for time. Time is not in the structure of the universe, but we live in time. We, at our scale, in our region of the universe, are immersed in something which is the flow of time. So time is not a universal thing. The universe is not something that clicks in time. Time is more a local thing, an approximate thing, but nevertheless, it's enormously important for us. We are beings, we are creatures of time. We cannot even be thought without time. We cannot think, we think in time. In fact, I think that to understand what time is, which is a fantastic question, a major open question today, we should not just look at physics, at the universe outside us, but we should also look at ourselves. And that's not the first time it happened. If we look at the sky turns around us. The sun moves, the stars move, the moon moves. So the cosmos seems to be moving around us. And we ask why, what's happening, and Copernicus understood it. It's not the cosmos, it's we that are turning. The Earth is turning, so we see this movement of the cosmos. So we understand the movement of the sky, not by looking at the sky, but at looking at the Earth, at ourselves. And I think we will understand better the flow of time, not looking at nature, but at looking at ourselves.